They push. We push. Every once in a while, we push hard enough that the light breaks through the clouds and a world beyond the war glimmers, just out of reach. The war is the world, and the world is the war. But behind every gun sight is a human being. We are those people. We are the jaded, and we are the naive. We are the honorable and the criminal. We are the bound for legend and the lost to history. We are the knights of the sky, the ghosts in the desert, and the rats in the mud. These are our stories.
All that fun. Well, we need a fresh batch of salt on you. Here's those good people. More artillery! Fire!
Been looking at your papers.
Don't worry about me, sir. I'm ready to do my bit for King and Country.
Listen, son, you find forward and reverse when you're told you'll do all right for me. Grab those, would you? Come and meet Big Bess. Woman of your dreams.
And our new driver, boys.
No, don't swear it. She does not like it when you swear. Finch, Abrams.
I've done this before.
Done what before?
Mind your business with manners. Listen, don't worry. She'll look after you, yeah?
All right, boys.
This is the big one. Our orders are to punch through the German line, destroying artillery positions as we go. Finch.
Yes, sir.
After lads. We'll advance on the French town of Cambrai, where I have been assured there is wine, women, and song.
So you should enjoy that.
I'm the man is wine.
Jesus. Are we in safe hands or what, boys?
All right, my lads.
Remember, boys, do your jobs. Take care of each other. Macbeth will take care of you.
May the Lord have mercy on our souls.
Get through this together, right, Edwards?
What?
Full ahead, driver!
Killed! Edward!
fire mission. It started, sir. So.
Boys. Nice server, with your lads.
Townsend. Is that right?
All we got out here is blind orders and chance. Which you'll do for us first, you reckon?
I'm sick of your lip, McManus.
Aye, aye, sir.
Yeah, don't start it up.
See more than 20 yards.
We're pushing through. Edwards, I'll drive. You jump out and scout ahead.
Don't be a hero, lad. Just do your job.
She needs new spark plugs.
Check how far that village is. Can you see it, son? Can you see the village?
Yes. Yes, I see it.
And what about our tanks? Can you see any of our tanks down there? Edwards?
Yeah. But they're not ours anymore.
Sounds like one of our best needs is down in that village.
All right. Let's go, Edwards. Let's go.
Good luck.
Tank is going nowhere and he'll be dead by morning. We're fucked.
What's it, you? You're just going to abandon the mission, are you?
Don't you get it? Finch, Pritchard, all of us. We've been fucked all along.
If that's what you want, McManus, then just go.
Don't you ever talk to me like that. I've ran more fucking missions than you have had all dinner, son.
McManus, just fucking go.
My way back there.
There's no right way in a place like this.
We'll find one. You're the driver.
Oh, nice work, boys.
Yeah. We did good, didn't we?
Aye.
Boys, sir, that's the last of them.
Let's get moving.
I've done everything right. Everything. My whole son in life. All I've done is live my life by the manual. By the manual! What's wrong with you? You stupid. You stupid bloody machine! Come on. Come on, Bess. Pull yourself together and work with it. Fuck's sake, I thought you liked to bloody well fight!
What do we do now, Driver?
We walk.
I have nothing left to bet, you idiot.
The plane.
That's rich. Oh, why the hell not? I've got you beaten anyway. What have you got? Wipe your mouth, Blackburn.
That wasn't supposed to happen.
But you know, I'll be taking that plane anyway.
What the bloody hell? You lost, I beat you.
The thing is, Rackham, it's a very beautiful aeroplane, and you're kind of a jackass.
I beat you fair and square, goddammit! Stay the hell away from my kind! Oh, you bastard! You can't do this to me! I beat you! I beat you!
My name's Clyde Blackburn. I'm a pilot and a gambler.
I'm George Rackham! I'm George bloody Rackham! Listen to me! You bumped the keys off my aeroplane!
If you asked me to name my biggest fault, I'd have to tell you. I'm just not a very honest person.
Welcome aboard! I'm Wilson, by the way. You must be George Rackham.
Sure, I'm Rackham. I'm your guide. Come on. Let's get this kite up in the air.
You're George Rackham, son of the 4th Earl of Windsor.
That's right.
What are you doing? We should turn back!
To hell with base!
Accidentally discovered where Germans were keeping their munitions for half the Western Front. And Wilson's pictures would help HQ launch a major assault. There was just one problem.
I'm not sure about this.
Oh, come on! We did a great thing. We'll get medals for this.
We weren't even supposed to be there.
When the commander sees these pictures, he won't care. We did a great thing. We can do it again.
I'll make you a deal. If we pile up on this, then you need to promise me that you'll get me back in one piece.
Sure thing.
Promise. I need your word.
Okay, I promise.
Stay here. And don't cause any trouble.
You know, I did like the guy. But he was kind of naive.
Sir, you might want to take a look at these.
Saints alive, your man must be one
hell of a pilot. Before we knew it, we were back in the air. Our mission? To clear the way for the bombers so they could blow that fortress all to hell. First, we'd have to down the barrage blimps. Jesus, imagine being a lookout on a blimp. Bad luck, Fritz. Next, we'd have to deal with their anti-aircraft trucks. The assault was already in full swing when we got there. We'd have to deal with all those defenses, then escort our bombers to their target when they arrived.
Bombers are here!
Oh, shit! Quick!
Hang on!
The bird was busted. She buried her nose in no man's land a half mile due west of where I went down.
We're in no man's land. We need to go now.
I can't get up.
Shit.
Hey.
I'm sorry.
But you promised to give me back in one piece. Just keep it down. What about medals?
I'm being heroes. I'm no hero.
But you gave me your word. Your bleeding word. So you think our decent bloke was going to help me?
Oh, you're a liar. No good bastard.
Who looked me in the eye and finish it? Which is it? Put your cards on the table, Blackburn. Thank you.
You're not George Rackham, are you? Son of the fourth bloody Earl of Windsor. I'm not even you think I am. Oh.
Let's get out of here.
Wilson said I was a no-good, lying son of a bitch. I brought him home because I think he's probably right. And I hate that fact more than I can tell you.
This guy's a bloody hero!
No, he's nothing of the sort. He's a cheat, a thief, and a liar. And he'll answer for his crimes. That's right, Blackburn.
To the farm, are you?
I'm gonna speak up for you, you know, at the court martial. It might do you some
good. I
doubt
it, but thanks.
Wilson, with me, I need a gunner.
Over here, I'll do it. Rackham, let me help.
You don't deserve to fly.
Wilson, if I'm gonna die, I'm gonna die up there.
Let's do this.
You sure you don't want to send this one out?
Not a chance.
There. You and your big mouth.
You okay? Logan? We need to take out that flat gun.
Okay! I've got your back!
That gun is knocking seven shades out of our lot. We have to grab it!
Straight ahead. Boom!
Careful!
Firing at us from everywhere.
I'll stay out here. Keep moving. I see it. He's over there.
That's the guy.
Selfish man who risked his own life to save another, and in doing so, found he was saved himself. Things get mixed up in wartime, though, and you'll probably hear other versions. A rogue pilot who stole a plane, who killed his buddy, then lied, cheated, and murdered his way across half the Western Front, only to escape court-martial in the chaos of an air raid. But don't listen to any of that. What you heard from me is the truth. I wouldn't tell you if it wasn't. Would I?
Are you all right? We're ready for you to cut the cake. Wow, these are incredible.
Yes, it was an incredible time.
You looked very handsome in that uniform.
That's not me, that's Matteo.
Oh, of course. I'm sorry, Dad. Take as long as you need.
No, no, it's okay, Tesoro. It's time I told you what happened to him. It was during our last battle together, just a few days after our 21st birthday. My brother's battalion had been ordered to capture a fort deep into enemy territory. I wasn't going with him. I was part of a special unit with a different mission. Our task was to support Matteo's battalion. We were a proud unit. We changed it all for Italy. The Ardite. They were targeting Matteo's unit below me. So I do the only thing I can.
Were you still safe behind your armor?
Of course, of course. Nothing could dent it. But then the planes veered away. When I got up, I thought I had died and gone to hell. They blew up the mountain. They buried us. They buried themselves.
Oh, God. Matteo.
I had to find him. So I went down into that hell. It was my only choice. I still think about that field. Every day. And almost stopped looking. Started giving in to the hope that Matteo had escaped. And then...
No! No!
He never got older. And here I am, still. Who decides such things?
Frederick Bishop?
Oh, God.
Hey, are you Frederick Bishop?
Nope. He's dead, sorry.
But isn't this your picture?
I suppose so.
Jack Foster. I'm in new charge.
No, you're not.
You have to take this kid off me.
Of course not. He came all this way just to see you. Frederick Bishop, the pride of Australia. Been lied about his age to get past conscription.
You know Morse code? Yes.
Follow me!
Where do you think you're going?
You.
Let me go. Yeah, okay, you're staying here. And you'll move up with rear command only after I fire the signal flare. Yes, sir?
Yes, sir.
Try to stay out of trouble. Things first. Yeah, come on, stand up. Follow me. I'm in here. Yes, I'm out. Right in your shoulder. That's it. Cheeky answer, bud. No, that's it. Point it where you want to shoot. That's it. Okay. Put your feet apart a little bit.
I was beginning to think I already lost my Australians. You, the boy. We need a runner for the front lines.
Really?
No.
Yes.
No.
You can't make the kid do it. we'll just stumble into a firefight and get killed.
No, I can do it.
No. I'll do it.
Fine. You're here with me, and you will be running.
You got falling lines across the board.
That's what I thought. Bishop, go tell rear command that we'll be moving up.
Hey, don't worry. I can handle myself here.
Head down. Got him. No open areas. Got it?
Got it.
Full scale retreat. They're gonna shell the village and the fort to cover us. We need to get out now.
I sent men up to secure the fort.
A dead man? Who went?
Only those who volunteered, so naturally, all of them.
Fucking kids.
But you remember being his age?
Foster. Fuck. I gotta get that kid.
Go. I'll pretend I didn't see you.
This isn't on you.
Of course it is. One more death for me to live with. Go, go, you don't have much time.
Again? You sure you don't just want to shoot me?
Come on.
Let's get you out of here. This place is about to come down any moment.
No, we can't leave. There are still hostiles coming, and we can't outrun them without wounded.
You get going then. I'll cover your retreat.
The bishop is still on.
I'll make it look like I'm capturing the fort. It'll be enough distraction.
Once you get past Allied lines, send up a flare. Let me know you're safe. I'll make my retreat then.
Oh, so you're disobeying orders now?
Well, I assume you did to come here.
Yeah.
You're a proper Aussie now. Gotta look the part.
Right. Up and at him, lads! Let's go.
Thank you.
Arabian Desert. A vast ocean of drifting sands and scorched, sun-baked rocks. Beneath these endless dunes, oil. The lifeblood of our new mechanical century. For more than 400 years, the Ottoman Empire has ruled these lands, controlling all that's to be found here. But the Ottomans do not rule unopposed. Small bands of Bedouin rebels have united to overthrow the empire. They strike without warning and then vanish into the desert. Fighting alongside them is a lone British officer whose exploits have earned him wide renown. The world has taken to calling this man Lawrence of Arabia.
You did not think we would be fast enough to catch you here, did you? Lawrence of Arabia. Actually, I was rather depending on it. Eh, Lawrence? Well, this is very clever. Now the hunter becomes the hunted. So who might you? How enchanting you are, my dear.
Ahmed.
I'll show you enchanting. If it weren't for you, I'd be free.
Free, is it? You'll be free when you're dead. And I'm happy to tell you, the Empire intends to grant you all this freedom very soon. Even now, an engine of destruction scours this desert, obliterating your allies, your families, your homes. Soon there will be nowhere to run! You know,
and all that you love
will be ashes. You will all be free.
Die.
Oh, you animal!
Zara!
Now I understand that you would like nothing more than to strip the flesh from that man's feet and send him off into the desert naked to die. But think about it.
I'm sorry. My friend here, she can be a little brusque.
You're going to tell me how to lie to your train so we can lure it into a trap and destroy it.
Impossible. To even begin to talk to that train, you wouldn't need an entire book of communication codes.
Oh, like this one.
You can never stop the progress of machines! One day, the whole world will take your lands and the precious black gold beneath its sands.
We shall see, my friend.
Of course, obtaining the codebook was not enough. To destroy this iron dragon, this Canavar, as the Ottomans had named it, we had to send 3 encrypted messages in order to stand down. There were Ottoman outposts scattered along the railroad tracks. The commanders there carried high-priority message captures. We had to use those to send our orders. Infiltrating the village wouldn't be easy. A full detachment of Ottoman soldiers had occupied it. The Ottomans had chosen an isolated location for their desert outpost. It seemed lightly defended. It was also well stocked with arms and equipment. The ancient ruins were all that remained of a civilization now lost to time. The Ottoman Empire brought in the modern world with a host of armored vehicles and field guns. 3 commanders to eliminate, 3 personal message capsules to be stolen. And then sent with our false orders. How Zara tackled this dangerous and audacious mission was up to her.
Ah!
You see, the message had already been sent, my dear. Not the message you would have wanted. Lawrence was such a good host. It almost seemed rude to escape. I made sure to note the location of Lawrence's camp, of course. Which means the train knows too. Weiss, you told that train everything was clear. But I told it exactly where to attack. The beast has your scent, my dear. And it's coming to slaughter you and your little band of rebels. First, the firestorm from the cannon. Then, up close with the troops to slaughter any survivors. The legend of Lawrence of Arabia dies tonight.
Away just in time. Tell Kitchy was a fool to think we'd ever stay after he escaped.
The carnival won't stop hunting us.
No, it won't. Let me think.
The train's coming a long way. So it'll have to stop to take on water. That's where we strike.
Agree. I'll deal with any sentries that bring explosives on the track.
Yes, and I'll rally our fighters.
When I blow the lines, the train will be trapped. So when you hear the blast, you need to attack them with everything you have.
It's good. But you know that there's a chance the men may not come. You may set off those explosives and find you're out there all alone. You know that.
I guess I won't know either way until I set it off.
Yes, no.
Vengeance can be a sweet or bitter brew. How did you find Azara?
And you're right, we do need to think bigger, act bigger. Maybe even the Suez Canal. Tell me. What do you know about battleships?
Will be won by one side or the other. Guns will rust, grass will grow, and there'll be nothing left of any of this. The land will heal itself, as everything does in the end. We'll be long gone by then, but maybe not forgotten. History only remembers one in 1,000 of us.
and the future will be filled with stories of who we were and what we did, how we lived, how we fought, and how we died. When this is all over and the war is won, they will remember us. But until that day comes, we will stand. We will look death in the eye, and we will.